Hello guys, welcome back to Tutorials Point. This is the video lecture we'll be focusing on intents. Now, what are intents basically? Intents are those parts of the application which we use to send message or to communicate between one or the other. Like for example, if you click on the messaging application drawer, you get a proper inbox which shows the list view of all the conversation threads. You click on one thread, you are redirected to a different page which shows the entire conversation history. Or else, if you open up your WhatsApp application, you see the list of all the chats, you click on a chat, you go to the next page, it shows you the chat history. You use the camera, you open up the camera, you are able to see a proper camera view which would be loading the entire image for you. You click on the gallery button or the decent photos and you are taken to a new directory or a new application for that matter. So now what is intent basically? How does the communication between applications happen? Say if I want to communicate with in between activities in my application or I want to communicate with some other application, I need intents for it. Intents are basically message passing objects which we use to request an action from other app component. A component can be anything. It can be a service, it can be a broadcast receiver, it can be activity. There are many ways in which we can have this communication. Let's see them. There are two main. We call them the implicit and the explicit. Say, as we have done it in the phone call and in the SMS also, if we simply click the phone call or if we simply fire the action underscore call intent, then we are able to directly make a call. We don't need to mention anything else. How is it possible? It is possible because Android has some specific intents predefined which allows other app to call that particular application. See, I want to open calculator, the Android's by default calculator. I'm given an intent for that. I call that intent and I'm able to fire up my calculator. So, not a specific component, but instead declare an action to perform which allows component from another app to handle it. Like if you want to show the location on a map, you can use an implicit intent to request that another capable app showing the location, right? Like say, if you want to show the location, then I can fetch the Google Maps app and to show the location. Now say, I want to communicate or I want to traverse between my application, like between activities in my application or service in my application. At that point in time, I use the explicit intent. It basically specifies the component that starts by name. It's a proper class name. To start the component from your app, right? Because you know the class name of the activity or the service you want to start. Know this thing, we actually mention the entire activity name or the entire class name because we know what is the class name that you want to start because either we own it or we are having the information about it. For example, starting a new activity in response to a user action, like say a user clicks the login button, you take the credentials and show it on the next page that yes, you have been logged in. Or you start a service to download a file in the background, or you start a service to download some music or some file. All these things are started because of intent. Now let's see, how do we fire up intent? The explicit intents for which we know the entire details of the intent, we simply use the intent class, make the object and call the default constructor. This is the calling class and this is the destination which I want to call. I simply target that start activity, I pass the intent, I'm able to launch the intent of my application. And if this intent runs fine, this activity is registered in the manifest file, and if everything goes fine, second activity would be shown up to the screen and it would start from its own create. Now, say I want to start implicit intent. By implicit intent, I mean intent that are predefined. Like in this one, we are trying to fire the contacts. How we do that? We create a new intent, we set the action that I want to open the action view, and then our data is contacts, contact URI, and I start this intent. This would also result in a similar result. Only difference is that here I was knowing the class names, the class path, and here I'm unaware of all these things. I only know about is my action and my data that I want. Now, we have three three main components which we can call, the first one being the start activity, second being a service, and third being a broadcast receiver. To start an activity, we simply call the start activity method. For a service, we use the start service method. For a broadcast, we use send broadcast. Now let's see all one by one. An activity represents a single stream. We have already read it. Two, you can create a new instance of an activity by passing the intent, as we did in the previous example, in the start activity method. The intent describes the activity to start and carries any necessary data. The data that we are talking about would be done in a practical demo wherein I would be showing you how we pass data. There's a function known as input extra, which we add to the intent, and we are able to fetch the data and read the data in the resulting application or resulting activity. To start a service is a component that performs something in a background without a user interface. You can start a service to perform a one-time action like downloading a file by passing it in the start service method. The intent describes the service to start and carries any necessary data, obviously, like the one we did it for activity. Now, a broadcast is basically that we receive, right? The system delivers the broadcast. So what happens is whenever the system boots up or your device starts charging or it's low on battery, we deliver a broadcast to other application by calling the function that is send broadcast and send order broadcast. Like as we did in the broadcast receiver, how do the applications that are looking for a broadcast know that a broadcast has been fired up? Based on the intent, whenever an intent filter is matched, like I say phone restart, so all the manifest files that are having the intent filter as phone restart, all these intent filters are matched up, and whenever the phone is restarted, a broadcast is sent. That broadcast is sent using the intent, and as a result, all the applications that are trying to fetch that intent would be able to have that messages that the phone has been successfully restarted. Now let's see how do we actually work on intents. Basically, intents are small component for message passing. We would be having an activity and another activity. We would be trying to open one activity to another, passing the data, and also we would be trying if we can have some predefined or some implicit intent also working. So let's go to Android Studio and see how it works. Hello guys, welcome back again. Now we will be seeing a quick demo on the intent. As we have seen about intent and how intent actually works, what are the components of intent. So now we would be seeing a demo in which we would be having one XML file. Let me show you the XML file. I've already done it over here. This is my XML file. On click of this button, I would be navigated to this XML file, right? This XML file is having a small text view named as show data, right? And it would be showing some content that I passed from my main activity. I hope the situation is very much clear to you. On click of this button, we have to go to a new activity. So let's first create a new activity. So we create a new Java class. We write it as custom activity. The super class for this class would be the activity class. I click on OK and it has created a new activity for me. Now we will be taking up this activity later. First, go to the activity file of this intent, Android intent demo, or this main activity, and see what we have to do in this particular application. So we go to the main activity.java. Here in the onCreate method, I would be creating the button object for my button that is present in the XML file. I name it as button. I write it as find view by ID r.id.button. I save my project. Okay, now I set the onClick listener on my particular button with the new anonymous class. Yeah, so here's my onClick listener. In the onClick listener, I have to make an intent as, say, intent new intent. It is going from main activity dot this to custom activity dot
class. Now let me add some data in this intent. Intent dot put extra. I put A over here and I pass my name main act. I pass the name of the activity as, okay, you can pass anything over here, like main activity is the source. After this you start activity. And in this one, you pass the intent. Now, what we will be doing in our next activity, like this one, that is custom activity or Java. First, we would be creating a onCreate method. In the onCreate method, I first set content view. I pass the resource r dot layout dot custom view. This was my custom view. If you remember, it's having a empty text view, right? Now I need to get the particular value that I passed from. Now I need to get the string that I passed over there into this data, and I do it like this. Now I create the object of the text view. Name it as label, typecast into text view, find the view by ID, and set the data. Now after this, the last bit is remaining is I need to go to my manifest file and register my application, my activity over there. Custom activity. I need to pass the label also. After this, I pass the normal intent filter. Action is and write dot intent action dot main. With this, if I run my application and I click on the button, I should be navigated to the next screen. Now let's see how is it running on my phone. So I open up the phone for you. I go to the other screen and this is output that I got. Main activity is the source. So I hope you guys have got the concept of intent over here clearly. So thank you guys for tuning in, for staying with us. Stay tuned as we will be taking you through the other lectures and other UI controls and other Android topics in detail. Thank you.